गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू दिस ऑनलाइन टीचिंग क्लासेस ऑफ एकेडमिक वर्ल्ड स्कूल बेमेतरा। टुडे अगेन वील कंटिन्यू द टॉपिक दैट इज सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम इन ह्यूमन विच इज फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट चैप्टर। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी स्टडीड अबाउट द अदर टू कॉम्पोनेंट्स दैट इज ब्लड एंड ब्लड वेसल्स। टुडे वील स्टडी द स्ट्रक्चर एंड वर्किंग ऑफ ह्यूमन हार्ट। सो फर्स्ट वॉट इज हार्ट? इट इज एक्चुअली रेडिश इन कलर एंड इट्स अ पंपिंग ऑर्गन विच पंप्स ब्लड थ्रू आउट the body. Just see here, what is the shape of the heart? It is actually the size of a closed fist of a non-working hand. Suppose this is a non-working hand, it is the size of a closed fist. And the weight of human heart is 250 gram to 300 grams. 250 grams in females and 300 grams in male. It varies approximately. The function is that it pumps blood throughout the body, helps in circulation of blood. The color is red. The size is of a closed fist. The weight is 250 to 300 grams. And it is covered by a membrane called pericardium. And the heart is divided into four chambers. Means the heart is partitioned so that it avoids the mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. The chambers we'll see, though here is a diagram of a complex heart, will come here afterwards. Before that, we'll draw a simple diagram of heart to understand what are its chambers. Suppose this one is the heart. If we see, the heart is slightly tilted towards the left side. The heart is actually present inside the thoracic cavity in between the two lungs, tilted slightly towards the left side. We know that humans are bilaterally symmetrical. That means if we divide the body into two equal halves, if we divide, the body is divided into two equal halves. But do you really think that the heart will be divided equally? No. Because the heart is shifted or tilted slightly towards the left side. We'll see how it is chambered. Roughly we understand there is a groove kind thing which separates the auricles from ventricles. How it will do, draw it? It separates. This groove is called coronary sulcus. This is a depression or a groove that will separate the auricles from the ventricles. The upper two chambers are called the auricles and the lower two chambers are called the ventricles. Auricles are the receiving chambers, smaller in size and thin walled as compared to ventricles. And there is a depression here which is called interventricular sulcus. And this is again a depression, and here is a septum which we call interventricular septum. Let me label it. This one is coronary sulcus. This one is interventricular septum. This septum divides or partitions the two ventricles. Similarly, here you will find interauricular septum which will separate these two arteries. We can label it interauricular septum. Now, if we want to label it, first in biology, you have to understand to diagnose or to identify the left and the right side. Suppose I stand in front of you, this is my left side and this is my right side. So if I want to label it, this side will be the left side. So this is left auricle. I am using abbreviation. A stands for auricle. This is right auricle. So these two are the upper chambers which receive blood. And this is the left ventricle and this is the right ventricle. Right? This is the lower two chambers. So there are four chambers and all the chambers are partitioned to avoid mixing of blood. This is roughly we have understood, but if we see a section of human heart, it looks just like this. Though the diagram seems very complicated, but we will understand how different arteries and veins are there in the heart so that it can bring or carry blood towards or away from the heart. We'll understand. Just we'll begin from one side. Just have a close look onto the diagram. You will find the red lines here. These red lines indicates oxygenated blood which is coming from the lungs, and this blue lines represents deoxygenated blood, right? Just see here, pulmonary vein, this we have read in the previous class as well, that all the veins carry deoxygenated blood, but there is an exception, that is pulmonary vein which carries oxygenated blood. This pulmonary vein brings oxygenated blood in the left auricle. Now this enters into the left ventricle. Now here you will find a valve which prevents the backflow of blood, which is called bicuspid valve. The blood here comes and it goes out through the aorta to different parts of the body. In the body, when this oxygenated blood reaches, respiration takes place and carbon dioxide is released. Now the blood takes this carbon dioxide and becomes deoxygenated blood. This deoxygenated blood from the upper portion of the body, means from the head and the neck region, the vein that is carrying the deoxygenated blood is called superior vena cava, means it brings blood from the upper portion of the body, deoxygenated blood from the upper portion of the body, and inferior vena cava which brings deoxygenated blood from the lower portion of the body. And where it enters into the right auricle. Now see here, from the right auricle, the deoxygenated blood moves to the right ventricle. Again you will find the valve here. The function is same. It prevents the blood to go back. It prevents the backflow of blood. From the right ventricle, it moves towards through the pulmonary artery, and the pulmonary artery is this side and this side, right? So in this way, these pulmonary arteries will carry the blood to the lungs, from where it will be exchanged and carbon dioxide will be given out. So see here, the heart has again four chambers. The upper two chambers are called the right auricle and the left auricle, and the lower two chambers are the right ventricle and the left ventricle. Again, you have a septum here which separates this right and left ventricle. The left ventricle has thicker and muscular wall, more thicker and muscular wall as compared to right ventricle, because left ventricle pumps blood to different parts of the body. Here also you will find valve. Can you see here? These valves are called the semilunar valves, which prevents again the backflow of blood. So this is the diagram of human heart. If possible, at the end of the chapter, I'll make another video to teach how to draw these complex diagrams easily. But for the time now, we'll only see how it works and how the blood moves inside the human heart, right? So this is the structure of human heart. Next, we'll understand how it goes to the lung and how exchange of gases takes place. In previous classes also, I have told you that respiratory system and this transportation, that is the circulatory system, is somewhere interrelated, because it is the blood that brings or carries this oxygen and carbon dioxide for the exchange. We'll see here, right? And when the blood enters into the heart, takes this path, one complete cycle, it takes one complete cycle to move across the heart, it is called cardiac cycle, which is only 0.8 second. This 0.8 second cardiac cycle includes auricular systole, auricular diastole and a joint diastole. Together it takes 0.8 second, means blood entering into the heart, moving across all the chambers and then going out, it takes only 0.8 second, which we call it as cardiac cycle. We have completed this one. Now next we'll understand double circulation. What do you understand by the word double? Double actually means that twice, right? See here, once the blood is entering into the heart here, another time the blood is entering into the heart here. How many times is it entering? Two. The blood is entering into the heart twice. One more thing, see the auricles, they are receiving chamber. Here also auricles are receiving, here also auricles are receiving the blood. So auricles are called receiving chambers. See the ventricles, here ventricles are distributing. Here also it is giving out and here also it is giving out. So when ventricles are called distributing chambers, auricles are called receiving chambers, ventricles are called distributing chambers. And next, it is receiving the blood twice. That's why we call it as double circulation. We'll understand by drawing a schematic diagram of double circulation to understand how the blood enters and how it moves and which are the vessels that carry it towards and away from the heart. So draw this diagram neatly in your copy. Practice it twice or thrice so that you will attempt perfection. Right? I'm erasing this portion so that we can understand. So that we can understand the double circulation in human. Keep on taking down the notes in your copy so that you can study it afterwards. Also, I will give you assignment at the end of this lecture which you will completing in the copy and you will send it to me through ERP within very next day of the lecture, right? I'll draw a rough diagram of a heart here, a schematic diagram. Schematic means where we represent only by a kind of a flow chart. It's a kind of a flow chart. Suppose I draw it's a heart. Suppose I divide it into four chambers. Here I'll draw the lungs. Why the lungs are important? Because they will bring oxygen which will be taken by the blood. This is left auricle, this is right auricle, this is left ventricle and this is right ventricle. You have a valve here which is tricuspid valve and you have another valve here which is bicuspid valve. Now see how the blood travels. Draw along with me in your copy. If you have not started yet, start doing. Here are the body cells where respiration will take place. Right? Draw along with me. Now see here, what we are studying is double circulation. It is double circulation in human. From the name itself, we understand that double means twice. Entering of the blood into the heart twice is called double circulation. How it can be defined? It is the passage of blood twice into the heart, once in the left side and once in the right side to complete one cardiac cycle. We call it as double circulation. It is of two types. One is pulmonary. Wherever you get the word pulmonary, you understand that this word is associated with lungs. Pulmonary circulation, and second one is systemic circulation. We'll understand from here. Suppose the oxygen is coming, we know the oxygen is exchanged in the capillaries, in the alveoli act as the respiratory surface where the capillaries are invested very closely and exchange of gases takes place. This we have read. Oxygen is taken, this oxygen is brought to the left auricle by pulmonary vein. It is an exceptional case because vein usually brings deoxygenated blood. It is only the pulmonary vein which brings oxygenated blood. This is an exception one, so you have to remember it. So the blood, see how it travels. The blood from the lungs, which is exchanged and which is rich in oxygen, because it is taking oxygen here. So let me write here, oxygenated blood, oxygenated blood. This side, left side, it is oxygenated blood, rich in oxygen. It enters into the left auricle. Then from the left auricle, it moves to the left ventricle. Here you will find a valve called bicuspid valve. And from the left ventricle, it moves to the different body parts through aorta. Aorta, it is also called main artery. This main artery will carry the oxygenated blood from the heart to different parts of the body. Now tell me, we have read in the previous class, when this oxygenated blood reaches to various cells, respiration will take place because blood acts as a vehicle or a carrier of oxygen. It will reach, it will make the oxygen available to all the cells where respiration takes place, and the byproduct that will be coming out is carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide will bind with the hemoglobin in the blood to form deoxygenated blood, that is carboxyhemoglobin. So we will write here, this portion will be deoxygenated blood. Here what will happen? Respiration will take place. It will give out carbon dioxide, and now the deoxygenated blood will move. See here, it moves to the right auricle. From the right auricle, it will enter into the right ventricle, and from the right ventricle, it will move to the lungs for exchange through pulmonary artery. Now, where do we find this pulmonary and systemic circulation? The movement of blood from lungs to heart and back means this portion, this upper portion, from heart to lungs. The movement of blood from lungs to heart and back is called pulmonary circulation. So let me write here, this portion is pulmonary circulation. And this one, it is a, this lower portion is systemic circulation. What do you mean by this? It is the movement of blood between the heart and the different parts of the body. So double circulation can be, has two components. One is pulmonary circulation. One thing you have to remember, wherever you get the word pulmonary, you have to understand that this word is associated with lungs. It may be pulmonary circulation, it may be pulmonary vein, it may be pulmonary arteries. Pulmonary word means that that thing is associated with lungs. So pulmonary circulation is the upper portion, movement of blood between the lungs and the heart and back. And the movement of blood between the heart and different parts of the body is systemic circulation. This portion, left side, it is rich in oxygen because oxygen is carried from the lungs, oxygenated blood, and this side it is deoxygenated blood. So this is what we read about double circulation. Now what is its importance? What is the importance of double circulation in human? It ensures quick and effective supply of oxygen to different parts of the body to meet the energy requirement. That's the importance of double circulation in human. You might have heard people saying that the child is having a hole in the heart. Now tell me, where would you find this hole? And what do you mean by this word, hole in the heart? You might have heard people say. What happens? In the embryonic stage, there is a hole here between the left auricle and the left and the right auricle. Here you will find a hole where mixing of blood may take place in the embryonic stage. But when the child takes birth, this hole is closed and there is a partition between left auricle and right auricle. In some cases, in some exceptional cases, this hole does not close, and thus we say that this child or this person has a hole in the heart, which is a defective and it can be treated, right? So this is all about the double circulation in human. Okay, this portion we have completed. Next comes your heartbeat. What do you mean by heartbeat? It is the rhythmic contraction and expansion of heart. The contraction is called systole and the expansion or the relaxation is called diastole. What happens? What is this contraction and why this heart is going to beat? It will contract, systole, the blood will come down, the valves will be closed, prevent the backflow. When the ventricles will be contract, it will move to the respective vessels, and here you will find the semilunar valves, right? So, and why this heartbeat starts? You have a sinoatrial node in the right auricle, which is also called the pacemaker. What it does is, it generates nerve impulses, which transmits this nerve, this kind of electric impulses to the auricular ventricular node. From the auricular ventricular node, it is transmitted to the bundle of His, which is spread through the walls of the ventricle, and it makes the ventricles to contract, and thus the heartbeat is initiated. Heartbeat is nothing but a rhythmic contraction and expansion of the heart. What we understood is, contraction is called systole and the relaxation is called the diastole. This heart, which we call that the heart beats and we call it as dhak dhak, it is not actually dhak dhak. There are two heart sounds, which is lub dub. The first sound, lub, which is a low pitched sound for a longer duration of time, it the sound is generated when this bicuspid and tricuspid valves are closed. When this, the blood comes from the auricles to the ventricles, and these two, this bicuspid and tricuspid valve closes, the first heart sound comes, that is lub. And when the semilunar valves are closed, we get the second heart sound, that is dub. Dub is a high pitched sound, but it has shorter duration. So there are two heart sounds, that is lub and dub. How are we going to listen to it? We can listen these heart sounds with the help of an instrument called stethoscope. You might have visited the doctor. When you visit a doctor, you may find the doctor with this kind of apparatus. It is called stethoscope. What is to be done? This has to be put into the ear, and when you put it and you check the nerve impulse, you check the heartbeat, you can find the heart sounds. So this instrument is called stethoscope, which is helpful in listening to the heart sounds. So we have done this heartbeat. You might have also heard about, and what is the normal heartbeat of a human adult? The normal heartbeat of a human adult is 70 to 72 times per minute. It may increase slightly in case of excitement or heavy physical exercise. It may increase slightly, but the normal heartbeat is 70 to 72 times per minute. Next is the pulse. What is pulse? The pulse are the throbs which are felt in the superficial artery, that is the radial artery, over the wrist at the base of the thumb, this portion. If you visit a doctor, the doctor would first check your pulse rate. What he would do is, he would put his thumb over your wrist, because here he would find the radial artery, which is superficial artery, and the throbs which is felt is called the pulse. This pulse rate is equal to the heart beat. Means if the heart beat is 72 times per minute, the pulse rate is also 70 to 72 times per minute, right? And the next is the blood pressure. The blood pressure. When the blood forcefully flows, it exerts pressure on the elastic walls of the artery, and this pressure is called blood pressure. How can we define blood pressure? Is it is the pressure exerted by the forceful flow of blood on the elastic walls of arteries. How can we measure blood pressure? The blood pressure can be measured again by an instrument called sphygmomanometer. This sphygmomanometer helps to record the blood pressure. Again, the blood pressure, the normal blood pressure of a human adult is 120 mm of Hg, and the lowest is 80 mm of Hg. If it exceeds more than 120 and 80, we call it the person is having hypertension or high blood pressure. If it falls below 120 and 80, he has hypotension or he has low blood pressure. How is this blood pressure measured? Is there is an instrument called sphygmomanometer. I am going to show you. This is a sphygmomanometer where a mercury graded, here you will find the gradation, and you will find a cuff here which is fixed just above the elbow. In this portion, just above the elbow, it is tied tightly. You will find a cuff, and along with it you will find a rubber bulb. What happens? When you press the rubber bulb, you exert pressure here, the air is given in, you will find the rise here, and when you release it, the gradation here falls down. The maximum should be 120 mm of Hg and the minimum should be 80 mm of Hg for a human adult. So this is a sphygmomanometer which is useful to measure the blood pressure in human beings. So this is all about the circulation, the structure of heart, the working of heart, heartbeat, pulse rate and blood pressure. What you have to do is, students, you will make notes of it. Try to make notes of it so that you can study whenever required. And I'll giving you three assignments which you will be completing in any notebook. Take a pic of it and you will send it through ERP. You have to send the homework just the next day when the video is uploaded. So what are your three assignments? Write it down. The three assignments are, first is describe the structure of human heart. What you have to describe is the how is the shape, how is the size, where is the location, how many chambers, how is the auricles, why they are receiving chambers, why thin walled, why ventricles are called distributing chambers, why they are thick walled, and so on. You will do it. Second one, you will draw a schematic diagram to show double circulation in human. This is the schematic diagram, a kind of a flow chart which you will draw to show the schematic diagram of the double circulation in human. Third one is define heartbeat, pulse and blood pressure. These are the three questions which you will be completing, and you will send it to me by tomorrow. Okay? Thank you.